This is our 1948 Whizzer. Whizzer is a bicycle assembly kit that you really hooked onto a bicycle. So this bicycle is a roll fast, it's called. And you could order that kit and the dealer would install it for you. And it had a V-belt drive to the back wheel, and it was a single cylinder and a carburetor and one exhaust pipe with a flexi pipe coming off it. As a roll fast, it had a very nice suspension on the front too. And this particular one is very, very interesting for a lot of reasons. It's got all the little accessories on it here. It's got this neat little bulb horn that's disintegrating now, but it's still got the price tag on it from Eaton's, and nice little mirror on here and all the stuff it needed. It's got a choke over here and a throttle with a thumb operation. And of course it goes about 3 times as fast as you'd ever want to go on a bicycle. Some of the neat things about this though really come back to who owned it. This one came from Nova Scotia, and the fellow that owned this, he was in the Spring Hill mine disaster actually, and he had bought this, he'd ordered the bicycle and had come in from Montreal, and the dealer in Montreal had put it together for him and assembled it and then shipped it down to Nova Scotia. And when they got it out of the dealership, the man got on it and he was riding it home and he fell off. And that was it. They took it home and they parked it in there and it never went after that, and it still got the 1948 license plate on it. So it was a grand old survivor and a great story of something that would survive that long. And we're very proud of it and pleased to have it.
In 1936, there was a boom in motor scooter sales when companies like Salisbury and Cushman made quality machines. The idea of motorized bicycles was resurrected from the early 1900s by companies like Marmon, Powwow, and Wasp. They thought they could compete against the costlier scooters. The Whizzer bicycle engine was first produced in 1939 by Breen Taylor Engineering, a Los Angeles-based manufacturer of carburetors and airplane parts. By 1942, sales of the engine had not been very successful, having sold only 2,500 units. The Whizzer operation was then sold to Dietrich Kohlsatt and Martin Goldman. The first model was the Whizzer Model D. It featured a 1 3/8 horsepower engine. The kit sold for $54.95. They generally had a life expectancy of 1,000 miles, then they would self-destruct. In 1946, Whizzer introduced a greatly improved Model H, which sold for $97.55 and delivered 2.5 horsepower. From 1946 until 1948, they sold approximately 139,000 units. By 1943, World War II was well underway, and Whizzer Motors were forced to lobby the U.S. government for the right to continue production. They argued that the Whizzer was a great way for defense workers to travel to and from work. In 1948, the company sold its first pre-assembled motorized bicycle called the Pacemaker. Production ceased in 1965 because of the increasingly competitive bicycle engine market. The growing popularity of motor scooters and mopeds from Europe and Japan didn't help matters either. In 1997, Whizzer motorcycles were brought back into production in the same style of the originals, but with technological improvements.